Yes, friends. Now, the remaining part of the lesson, page number 77, becoming a World Heritage Site. Means, what are the important things which are very essential for becoming any site as a World Heritage Site? Yes, page number 77, first paragraph. There are 5 steps in becoming a World Heritage Site, the first of which is for a country or state party to take an inventory of its significant cultural and natural sites. This is called the tentative list, and it is important because nominations to the World Heritage List will not be considered unless the nominated site was first included on the tentative list. Next, countries are then able to select sites from their tentative lists to be included on a nomination file. The third step is a review of nomination file by 2 advisory bodies consisting of the International Council on Monuments and Sites and the World Conservation Union, who then make recommendations to the World Heritage Committee. The World Heritage Committee meets once a year to review these recommendations and decide which site will be added to the World Heritage List. The final step in becoming a World Heritage Site is determining whether or not a nominated site meets at least one of 10 selection criteria. If the site meets these criteria, it can then be inscribed on the World Heritage List. Once a site goes through this process and is chosen, it remains the property of the country on those territory it sites, but it also becomes considered within the international community. Yes, it is very important for our knowledge. How does any World Heritage Site or the world, our heritage will become a World Heritage Site? There are 5 steps, and we have to see in this passage. What are the 5 stages out of that? The first is, what is first one? The first one out of the 5 is, for a country or the state party, it should take the inventory of its significant cultural and natural site. It means inventory list. Detailed list. That country or the state, it should make the list of it. This is called the tentative list. It is called as, it is inventory or the detailed list. It is tentative. It is the tentative list. And it is important because nominations to the World Heritage List will not be considered. They will not be considered. They will never be considered unless the nominated site was first included on this tentative list. This is the first very important step. Second, next, countries are then able to select the sites from the tentative list to be included on the nomination file. Then there is a nomination file. Of state or nation. The third step is a review of nomination file. Third is review of nomination file by the advisory bodies consisting of International Council on Monument and Site and World Conservation Union. Then they make the recommendation of the World Heritage Committee, and when this committee recommend the World Heritage Committee meets once a year. It meets once a year to review these recommendations and decide which site will be added to the World Heritage Site. The final step is in becoming the World Heritage Site is determining whether or not the nominated site meets at least one of the 10 selection criteria. At least one out of 10 selection criteria. He should meet at least one criteria. Once the site goes through this process of 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, when it goes through these 5 steps, once the site goes through this process and is chosen, if it is finalized, then it remains the property of the country on those territory. It is the property of that country on that territory. But it also becomes considered within the international community. This is the way how any site becomes the part of World Heritage Site. Yes, and the last part of the lesson we'll go through. And the last is types of World Heritage Sites. Yes, page number 77. As on 2009, there are 890 World Heritage Sites in 2009. How many? 890. Now let us have the importance of the figure. In 2009 there were 890 World Heritage Sites. They are located in 148 countries. 689 of these sites are cultural and include places like Sydney Opera House in Australia and the historic center of Vienna in Austria. 176 are natural and feature such locations as the USA's Yellowstone and the Grand Canyon National Parks. 25 of the World Heritage Sites are considered mixed, that is, cultural and natural. Peru's Machu Picchu is one of these. Italy has the highest number of World Heritage Sites with 44. India has 36. 28 cultural, 7 natural and 1 mixed World Heritage Sites. The World Heritage Committee has divided the world countries into 5 geographic zones, which include Africa, Arab states, Asia Pacific, and in this Asia Pacific including Australia and Oceania, and the 4th is Europe and North America, 5th is Latin America and the Caribbean islands. Now see, what are the types of World Heritage? We have seen in 2009 there were 89 World Heritage from 148 countries, and 689 out of these 689 sites are cultural. These are cultural. Hundred and 76 are natural. and feature such locations as the US Yellowstone example, US Yellowstone and Grand Canyon National Parks. 25 of the World Heritage Sites are considered mixed. 25 are mixed. Yes, out of 8, 9, 0. 6, 8, 9 are cultural, 176 natural, and 25 are mixed. And World Heritage Sites considered mixed, that is, natural and cultural. Peru's Machu Picchu, you may have heard the name Machu Picchu, is one of these places. Italy, now out of these nation, Italy has maximum, that is 44 World Heritage Sites. India has 36. India has 36. Means highest number of World Heritage Sites are in Italy. Second is China. Second is China and third is India. Third is India. India has 36. Out of 36, 28 are cultural. 28 out of these. 28 cultural. 7 natural. 1 mixed. And 1 is mixed. In this way, we have the sum up of 36 World Heritage Sites in India. The World Heritage Committee has divided the world's countries into 5 geographical zones. Actually, the continents or geographical continents are different, and the classification of the World Heritage Committee for their work is different. First is Africa, second is Arab state, third is Asia Pacific, means which include Australia and Oceania, and Europe and North America are put in one group, and Latin America and the Caribbean are in the another remaining fifth group. Now, World Heritage Sites in danger. Now see, World Heritage Sites in danger. How these World Heritage Sites are in danger? You know very well the what is going on in the world. The world is on the verge of the Third World War. And whenever we say war, whenever simple world war comes to our mind, we know destruction, destruction and destruction only. Therefore, war creates the destruction, not only of the humans, but also of the people, the land, the buildings, the territory, the forests, the oceans, the natural things and everything. So, there are different reasons why the World Heritage Sites, those are in danger, no? Yes, World Heritage Sites in danger. Like many natural and historical cultural sites around the world, many World Heritage Sites are in danger of being destroyed or lost due to war, poaching, natural disasters like earthquakes, uncontrolled urbanization, heavy tourist traffic, and environmental factors like air pollution and acid rain. World Heritage Sites that are in danger are inscribed on separate list of World Heritage Sites in danger, which allows the World Heritage Committee to allocate resources from the World Heritage Fund to that site. In addition, different plans are put into places to protect and to restore the site. If, however, site loses the characteristic which allotted for it to be originally included on the World Heritage List, the World Heritage Committee can choose to delete the site from the list. To learn more about World Heritage Sites, visit the World Heritage Center's website at whsc.unesco.org. Now see, World Heritage Sites in danger. I have just mentioned before told you why they are in danger. Because the first important thing is war. Second is poaching. Third is natural disasters like earthquakes, uncontrolled urbanization because of the people. Urbanization is people go from village to the city and they include the more cities. The area of the city increases. They expand the city area. That is called as urbanization. It is given in the book. Heavy tourist traffic is there. One of the reason. Then the environmental forces. Air pollution. Acid rain. You are learning in 9th in chemistry or 10th. What is acid rain? What are the causes? On the different types of monuments. On the Taj Mahal also, there is the effect of the acid rain, and so the different industries around Taj Mahal on the bank of Yamuna were locked by the Supreme Court of India because they made the color of that Taj Mahal yellowish. The acid rain put that deformation or the making the color yellowish. So the Supreme Court has taken the cognizance and it has ordered to lock the different industries which harm, which were responsible for the acid rain in the area of the Taj Mahal. World Heritage Sites that are in danger are inscribed in a separate list. They made the list of the World Heritage Sites in danger. They allow the World Heritage Committee the resources from the World Heritage Fund. They allow the money or different arrangements. Their help is made by that committee. Fund to that site. In addition, different plans are put into place for protecting or restoring the sites. In India, Hampi, the ruins of Raja Ramadeva Raya Kingdom, Hampi, the capital city. The ruins of Hampi are even in the World Heritage. They are destroyed by the different type of the Muslims conquerors. They put forcibly that only kingdom of the Hindus in the south, and the result was dismantling the pious heritage of that Hindu king Raja Ramadeva Raya. They were destroyed, but even then UNESCO had made the committee, and when it came to that Hampi, visited, and they put that in the World Heritage. But as it was destroyed and it was in danger, and the government of India helped, and they rebuilt some constructions, and now it is again in the list of World Heritage. That is the tragedy of the heritage of the Hampi. In addition, different plans are to put into the places to protect and restore the site. If, however, the site loses the characteristic which is allowed for it to be originally included on the World Heritage list, the World Heritage Committee can choose to delete the site from the list. The example of the Hampi is same. It was deleted from the list. But then the government of India made the plan to restore the beauty and the strength of those construction, those artifacts. To learn more about the World Heritage Sites, you could visit World Heritage Center's website at whc.unesco.org. Yes, here is the end of the lesson, but we will see, for our interest and for our knowledge, we should know what are the World Heritage, what is the importance of World Heritage Sites in the reference to our country or our nation. In the World Heritage Sites, according to June 2020, the figures in the book were according to 2009. The latest figures are, the World Heritage Sites are 1,121. In India, there are 38 sites. And in Maharashtra, there are 6 sites. Out of those 6 sites, first is Alora, Ajanta and Ellora. They were founded in 2nd and 6th century. That is the grace of Indian culture. Third is Elephanta Caves near Mumbai. Fourth is Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Terminus, former Victoria Terminus. Fifth is Western Ghats. Yes, it is a natural World Heritage. Out of 9 World Heritage Western Ghats, 1 is in Maharashtra. You know the Western Ghats, that is the Sahyadri subcluster from Songadh in Gujarat to south of Tapi River, approximately 1600 km through Maharashtra state, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala to the Tamil Nadu till the southern tip of Indian Peninsula. Area is approximately 160,000 square kilometers. It is one of the world's hottest biodiversity hotspot with 7,402 species of flowering plants, 1,814 species of non-flowering plants, 139 mammal species, 508 birds, 107 amphibians, 6,000 insects, 290 freshwater fishes, and many undiscovered biodiversity found here even rivals that of Amazon. You know the Amazon. The Victorians and the Art Deco ensemble of Mumbai, that is Bombay High Court, Rajabhai Clock Tower, Eros Cinema, Convocation Hall, University of Mumbai, University Library of Mumbai. These are some spots which are included in World Heritage Sites. Yes, thank you. We'll see in the next lesson about the grammar and the exercise. Thank you very much.